Hello, OptaPlanner friend. In this video, I'm gonna show you a new simple way to start OptaWeb Vehicle Routing. It is a bash script that automates tasks that need to be done before starting the application and makes it easy to start it from the command line. So what it does, it downloads OSM regions from GeoFabric for you and stores them in a directory under your home directory. It lets you choose from the downloaded regions when starting the application. And lastly, it remembers the country codes assigned to each region so that you don't have to specify them in the run command. For the record, country codes are used to filter geosearch results when you search for locations by address. Please note that it is a bash script, so it only works natively on Linux and Mac OS. If you want to use the script on Windows, you might need to enable the Linux subsystem first. So the run script works in three different modes. The first mode is the Quickstart mode that starts the application with Belgium. This is because we have a built-in dataset with Belgian cities. So in the Quickstart mode, you simply run the script with no arguments and you can load the built-in dataset when the application start finishes. The other modes are the interactive mode that lets you download new regions and start the application with the selected region. Finally, there is the non-interactive mode that takes the working region as an argument. Let's now take a look at how the Quickstart mode works. If you open the OptaPlanner website and go to the download section, you can download the latest release of the OptaWeb Vehicle Routing distribution. When you extract the archive, you will see that in addition to sources and documentation, there is a bin directory with the application jar file and an executable script. When you start the script with no arguments, it will assume that you want to work with the built-in dataset, which requires Belgium, so let's just confirm this. And the script will start downloading the OSM file from GeoFabric. I will now speed up the video a little bit so that we don't have to wait all the time the file is being downloaded. When it's done, the script will start the application and we get to another point where I'll speed it up. Because when a fresh OSM file is imported, the routing engine first needs to build a road network graph out of it so that it can calculate the distances efficiently. Now that the application is running, we can switch back to the browser and load the built-in Belgium dataset. Another feature of the run script is the interactive mode. It is activated by the dash I option. In this mode, I can download additional regions without using a web browser and choosing the download file location. Let's try this out with a small island of Mayotte and hit D for download. The script mirrors the region structure from GeoFabric, so I need to navigate through Europe and then France to get to Mayotte Island. Once the file is downloaded, I can select it with its index number and start the application. This time there is no need to speed up the video because the Mayotte OSM file is very small and it's converted really quickly. And finally, there is the non-interactive mode that lets me switch between downloaded regions without going through the interactive mode, simply by providing the region name as an argument to the script. Let's see how it works. And that's it. You can learn more about the script if you go to optaplanner.org. navigate to the documentation section and open the latest OptaWeb Vehicle Routing documentation and read about running the application using the run script. So that's it for today, and see you in the next video.